Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to create a connector programmatically and connect two nodes. You will also see how to draw a connector using a drawing object, how to update and remove connectors dynamically, and how to customize the connectors using different types of segments and decorator shapes. First, I open a Blazor application where I have a Blazor diagram component with three basic shape nodes on it. If you want to know how to create this Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion Blazor components to it, follow the video linked in the card above. I run this application to show the initial output. The diagram canvas has been rendered with the three defined nodes. Now, I am going to show you how to create a connector programmatically and connect the first two nodes. Inside the uninitialized method, I create a connector named connector1. And set the ID as connector1. Next, I need to set the position for the connector using the source point and target point properties. In this case, I am going to connect the first node and second node, so I set the source ID as node1, which is the ID value of the first node. And target ID as node 2, the ID value of the second node. Next, I need to add this to a connector object and assign that object to the diagram component. To do that, I create an instance for the diagram object collection class of type connector with the name connector collection. I will add the newly created connector to the connector collection object. Then, I assign it to the diagram component using the connector's property. You can see a connector is added between the first and second nodes. Next, I am going to create a connector when a button is clicked. For this part, I am planning to connect the second and third nodes. To do it, I will use the Syncfusion Blazor button component by importing the Syncfusion Blazor button's namespace. And defining the button component. With the button content add connector. Then I add the event on click with the event handler add connector. I define the add connector event handler. And within it, I add the same code I used previously to create a connector. Since I want to connect the second and third nodes, I set source ID to node 2. Target ID to node 3. I also change the ID of the connector. When I click the button, a second connector is created and connects the second and third nodes. Next, let's see how to draw a connector using a drawing tool on the diagram canvas. I am going to activate the drawing tool with a button click. I'm going to use the same button I already have in place, but let me change the button content to draw a connector. To activate the drawing tool, I need to use the interaction controller. To access the interaction controller property, I create an instance for the diagram component inside the code section and add a reference to the component using the @ref property. Inside the addConnector method, I comment out the existing code and define the interaction controller. And set the interaction to once, because I want to draw only one connector. You can also select the continuous draw option to draw more than one connector at a time. Then, I need to specify the type of connector that can be drawn with the drawing tool. In this example, I am going to draw a straight connector. I define the drawing object and create a new straight connector here. Now, I click the button to activate the drawing tool and create a connector by drawing one. You can also add connectors to the diagram canvas from the symbol palette. Refer to the video in the card above to see how to do this. Okay, so far you have seen a couple ways to add a new connector. Now I will show you how to update and remove a connector from the diagram canvas. First, I will update the connector by changing its stroke color and stroke width on a button click. To do that, I add one more button to the page and set the content as Edit Connector. I add a click event with the event handler Edit Connector. Then, define the Edit Connector event handler and call the method BeginUpdateFirst. I define the style property. And set the stroke color to red. And stroke width to 2 pixels. Finally, call the endUpdate method. When I click the Edit Connector button, the connector's style is updated. You can update any property of the connector in the same way. To remove the connector from the canvas, within the Edit Connector event handler, I call the Remove method. As I am going to remove the first connector in the connector collection object, I set the index as 0 here. You can see the connector is removed when I click the Edit Connector button. By default, the connector renders as a straight segment. Apart from this default type, the Syncfusion Blazor Diagram component also supports orthogonal, bezier, and polyline connectors. Now, I will show you how to set the orthogonal segment type. Inside the onInitialized method, I define the type property and set the value to orthogonal. To display the orthogonal type of segment between nodes, the position of nodes should be in different x-axis or y-axis values. So, let me change the position of the second node with appropriate values. You can see the orthogonal type of connector is rendered. As you see here, the orthogonal connector renders in a flow, with bottom direction first, and then the right direction. If I want to customize the flow, I can use the direction property. To customize the segments in the connector, I define the segments property and create a new orthogonal segment. With type orthogonal. As I would like to display the right direction segment first, I set the direction as right here. I can also customize the length of this right direction flow. I set the length to 100 pixels. Similarly, I create another segment in bottom direction and 200 pixels length. Now, you can see the customized orthogonal segments in the defined flow. Similarly, you can customize the Bezier type connector. To know more, refer to the documentation link given in the description below. Notice, the source decorator is none and the target decorator is arrow by default. In addition to these default types, the source and target decorators have 10 more decorator types. They are open fletch, dimension line, closed sharp, indented closed, and many more is shown here. Now, I will show you how to set the diamond-shaped target decorator. I define the target decorator property and set the shape to diamond. The target decorator is now diamond in shape. Similarly, if you want to have a decorator at the source point as well, use the source decorator property. In this video, we have seen how to create a connector in the code behind of the diagram component to connect two nodes. We have also seen how to draw a connector using the drawing tool, and how to update and remove the connector from the diagram canvas. Lastly, we have seen the different types of segments and decorator shapes. If you would like to see the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like it and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.